Hello everyone, so in this video, we proceed with subtopic 4.3, inverse of matrices. So in this subtopic, we will learn on how to find the inverse of matrices. Kalau dalam bahasa Melayu dulu, belajar ini sebagai matrix songsang. Okay. So basically, there are three methods to obtain the inverse of matrix. First method would be adjoint method. For adjoint method, we have to use the formula. Kita akan pergi kepada formula ini sekejap lagi. The second method would be the use of property. And then the last one is elementary row operation. In this video, we will only focus about adjoint method, the first one. Okay, so finding inverse using adjoint method, basically we have to use the formula. Formula untuk inverse, it's fixed 1 over determinant of A times adjoint A. Itu kalau kita nak cari inverse of A lah. Itu memang dia punya formula. Okay. So, we have to bear in mind, ini yang selalu student confuse. Bukan confuse lah, dia salah salah konsep. Okay. Dia akan anggap A inverse tu, A to the power of negative 1 as an index. Dia macam pakai hukum algebra kat situ. So, tiba-tiba dia akan jadi 1 over A yang ada dalam awal ni. Which is the wrong concept lah. Kita tak boleh anggap benda ni sebagai algebra biasa. So, nak cari inverse A to the power of negative 1, notation dia, mesti guna formula. Okay, saya star kan. Itu formula, it's fixed. So, tak ada 1 over matrix A. Itu tak wujud. Kita dah cakap pun dalam first subtopic. Tak ada operation untuk bahagi yang melibatkan matrix. There's no division in matrices. Okay. So, next kita kena note dulu semua benda. So, if in order to find inverse matrix, first rule or first condition, our determinant cannot be equal to 0. Okay. Itu syarat pertama dia. Mesti tak boleh sama dengan kosong. Kenapa? Because our formula involving 1 over determinant of A. So, kalau determinant tu kita dapat kosong, nanti 1 per kosong keluar, make error. Tak boleh kat situ. So, syarat wajib dia, determinant cannot be equal to 0. So, this we call as non-singular matrix. For non-singular matrix, barulah matrix boleh wujud. If our determinant equal to 0, maksudnya bila kira-kira determinant dapat kosong, we call this as singular matrix. So when it comes to singular matrix, inverse does not exist. So bukanlah tak boleh determinant tu kosong. So kalau determinant sama dengan kosong, maksudnya dia singular. Bila dia singular, maksudnya inverse matrix does not exist. Okay. So for inverse matrix using adjoint method, we have two separate cases, 2x2 and 3x3. So kita pergi first example dulu. Example 2x2. So, we have to find adjoint matrix of A, hence find the inverse of it. Okay, ini tak ada dalam nota. Let's say we have a matrix A denoted as A, B, C and D. So, our adjoint in this case, ADJ stand for adjoint of A, so matrix A. So, the way we find it is for A and D, we swap the position. Kita tukar position tu. So, D akan duduk kat atas. A akan duduk kat bawah. And then for B and C, kita tambah negative sign. Negative B, negative C. And that's basically how we find the adjoint of 2x2 matrix. So for question, example 21, we have matrix A, 3, 1, 5 and 4. So our adjoint here would be 3 and 4, we swap the position. So we have 4 at the first row. And then 3 at the second row. And for 1 and 5, we add negative sign. Settle. Siaplah kita punya adjoint. Hence, so hence means by using our adjoint just now, find the inverse of A. So inverse of A, our notation is A inverse A to the power of negative 1. Using formula, 1 over determinant of A times with adjoint of A. So, macam mana nak cari determinant? If 2x2, kita punya formula, it's fixed. AD minus BC. So, 4 times 3 minus with negative 1 times negative 5. Okay. And then, adjoint of A, what we have found just now. So, I copy it back. After that, simplify this up. So we get 12 minus minus 5. So we have 1 over 7 times with matrix A. Oh, sorry, times with adjoint of A. Alright, and then for final part, we cannot leave our answer like this. Dia tak boleh ada skala outside of matrix. Make sure your final answer in the form of single matrix. So, kita kena darabkan dalam. So, 4 over 7, negative 1 over 7, negative 5 over 7, and last one, 3 over 7. Ini yang awak dah belajar masa SPM level sebenarnya. Kita ulang semula je lah. Saya letak satu soalan je. Okay. Kita proceed seterusnya on how to find inverse of 3x3 matrices by using adjoint method. So, example 22. Find the adjoint of B, hence find the inverse of B. Okay. Macam mana pula adjoint untuk 3x3? Okay. Ini fixed formula. Adjoint for 3x3 matrices, let's say saya kata adjoint of A, is basically cofactor matrix that we transpose. Itu cara nak cari dia. Totally different dengan 2x2. 2x2 tadi, yang AD tukar position macam tu je kan? Sekarang untuk 3x3, cerita dia dah jadi lain. It's basically cofactor matrix that we transpose. So, how do we find cofactor matrix? Okay. Kita nak cari sekarang cofactor matrix dulu. So, kalau dia nak cari matrix B, saya guna cofactor of B lah. CB maksudnya cofactor of B. Okay, so kita kena buka satu matrik besar. Dalam tu kita kena sediakan 9 modulus. Okay, so saya buat ada 9 modulus yang ada sign eh. So kita tadi kan start dengan plus. Ingat position, so minus and then plus. And then for second row dia akan start dengan minus, plus, minus. And then last row kita ada plus, minus. Plus. Okay, and then kita dah boleh tutup matrix tu. Alright. So, apa yang ada kat dalam setiap satu ni? It's basically minor kita. Sebab kalau cofactor, minor darab dengan sign. Sign sekarang kita dah complete kan all 9 signs. So, dalam setiap modulus tu kita nak kena letak minor. So, start with the first position yang atas ni. First row, entry 1, 1. Cara nak cari dia? Delete first row, first column. Ikut position kan? Ini position pertama. So, yang overlap dengan satu ni, semua kita delete. Itulah yang kita belajar kat subtopik 4.2 eh. Siapa rasa macam blur? Maksudnya dia belum tengok lagi video tu. Kena pergi tengok dulu. Okay. So, 2, 2, negative 1, 0. Now, kita nak pergi dapat orang sebelah dia pula. So, yang overlap dengan 3, saya delete. From here, we get 0, 2, negative 2, 0. Okay. Now, kita tukar pula. Kita delete pula column number 3. So, from here, we get 0, 2, negative 2, negative 1. Settle untuk first row. Now, moving on second row means kita kena delete. Second row tu kita delete. Okay. So, kalau saya nak dapatkan position yang kat depan ni untuk first column, second row, kita delete dulu first column. So, from there, we get 3, 2, negative 1, 0. Moving on, kita nak dapat untuk item yang kat tengah-tengah. So, kita delete pula second column. So, 1, 2, negative 2, 0. Okay, next one, third column pula kita delete. So, we get 1, 3, negative 2, negative 1. Settle for second row. Okay, now repeat the same process for third row. So, delete third row. For first one, kita delete first column dulu. So, we get 3, 2, 2, 2. Okay, and then pindah sebelah dia. So, delete second column. So, we have 1, 2, 0 and 2. Okay, last one, kita delete third column. So, 1, 3, 0, 2. So, once we complete all 9 cofactors, kita dah siaplah. Mencari satu ni. Okay. So, bila dah settle yang ni, kita kena dapatkan cofactor matrix tu, kena kira lah satu-satu. Macam mana nak kira dia, kita kena buat darab silang yang awak belajar tu. Okay. So, let's say yang pertama ni maksudnya kena buat 2 darab kosong, tolak 1 darab, negative 1 times 2. And then darabkan dengan sign yang ada kat 2. And then you have to do the same process for all 9 cofactors. So saya terus bagi jawapan ya. For first row kita akan dapat 2, negative 4, 4. After that, negative 2, 4, negative 5. And then last one, 2, negative 2, 2. Okay, settle. Siaplah kita punya cofactor. Okay. Tapi sekarang kita baru siap cofactor. Soalan tadi suruh cari adjoint. Okay, kalau dalam sebenar step nak cari inverse ni, ini step pertama kita lah. Saya label siap-siap lah eh. Ini step number one. Kita cari cofactor matrix. Alright. Now, kita pergi step number two. Find the adjoint of matrix. So, step number two. Find adjoint. So, using formula just now means adjoint of B will be equal to cofactor matrix B that we transpose. So, jawapan yang kita dah dapat tadi, kita kena transpose. What is transpose? Awak dah belajar dalam 4.1. Interchange between row and column. So, saya start dengan first row. Kita tukar jadi first column. So, first row 2, negative 4, 4. That will be our first column now. So, negative 2, 2, negative 4, 4. And then our second column would be negative 2, 4, negative 5. And then last column would be 2, negative 2, 2. Hati-hatilah banyak negative plus minus kat situ. Settle. That will be adjoint of B. Okay. Next soalan dia, hence find the inverse. Okay. Saya sambung step seterusnya. Step number 3, in order to find the inverse, we have to find the determinant of B. Okay. So, determinant of B, kalau awak dah belajar kat 4.2, it's basically original entry darab dengan cofactor. Jalan kerja kita main tutup-tutup tu kan. Tapi kat sini kita dah senang sebab cofactor yang tutup-tutup tu kita dah kira kat depan ni. Yang ada banyak ni, 9 item. So from here, kita tinggal pilih one row or one column. Yang kita nak lah. Okay, choose one row or one column. Kita pilih second row lah. Saya ambil second row from original sebab itu yang ada 0 entry. Okay, so second row from our question. And then choose pula second row in step number one. Cofactor matrix just now. Itu. So, saya dah highlight dua ni. Okay, kita nak cari determinant. Kita darabkan ikut correspond entries. So, Z determinant of B here will be 0 akan darabkan dengan negative 2. So, 0. Second entry, so plus with 2. Times 4. And then last one plus with 2 times with negative 5. So from there calculate determinant of B would be negative 2. Ha. Dia tiba-tiba jadi macam pendek sikit kan compare dengan 4.2 tu sebab yang tu kita ada buat tutup-tutup. Sekarang ni tak perlu buat lagi tutup-tutup tu sebab kita dah cari kat step number 1. So, ini saya pilih second row. Up to you, awak boleh pilih any row, any column. We have 6 option there. Tapi nak senang, pilihlah row or column yang ada nombor 0. Okay. Settle step number 3. Now, kita nak masuk last step. Step number 4. How to find the inverse. So, step number 4, kita key in lah dalam formula. Okay, what is our formula? Inverse of B is basically 1 over determinant of B times with adjoint matrix. Okay, so determinant just now is negative 2. So, negative half times with adjoint. Adjoint is our answer in step number 2. So, 2, negative 2, 2. Negative 4, 4, negative 2. And then last one, 4, negative 5, 2. Okay, and then final step, make sure our final answer as single matrix. Kalau ada skala outside ni, awak memang kena multiply inside. So, our final answer for B inverse, start with our first row is negative 1, 1, negative 1. Second row, 2, negative 2, 1. And then last row will be negative 2, 5 over 2, negative 1. Okay. Settle. Alright. So, jalan kerja memang panjang. Jangan risau. Kalau inilah keluar masa assignment, markah banyak kat dalam soalan ni. Okay. Yang penting key point dia, step pertama ni. Cofactor matrix mesti betul. Kalau kat sini yang salah tutup-tutup, sini ada salah, confirm step number 2 salah. Bila step number 2 salah, step number 3 salah, all confirm lah yang kat hujung tu awak punya inverse pun akan salah. Okay, macam mana kita nak double check jawapan kita betul ke tak? We can do this using calculator. So, during first lecture, saya dah ajar kan nak masukkan matrix dalam calculator macam mana? Kita boleh check jawapan kita betul ke tak? Okay, kita masukkan dulu matrix B dalam calculator. So, pergi ingat menu and then choose option number 4 matrix. And then kita nak define matrix. Sebab ni matrix B, saya ambil lah matrix B number 2. Okay, we have 3 rows and then 3 columns. So, kita dah nampak dah keluar lah 3 by 3 matrix. And then key in our elements. So, 1, 3 and 2. And then we have 0, 2, 2. And then last one would be negative 2, negative 1, 0. And then AC button. Okay, after that kita nak keluarkan matrix tu semula. Apa yang kita dah key in? So, option button. Choose matrix B lah sebab kita dah key in matrix B tadi. And then choose button ni. X to the power of negative 1. Yang sebelah sign button. So, dia akan keluar matrix B inverse kat situ. So, tekanlah button equal. And then automatically. Oh, saya tarik sekejap. Dapatlah jawapan apa yang kita kira tadi. So, from here actually kita bolehlah semak apa yang kita dah kira panjang-panjang tadi. Betul ke tak sebenarnya? Penat kan kira dah banyak-banyak, tiba-tiba jawapan akhir salah. So, calculator ni penyelamat lah. Boleh check jawapan akhir awak betul ke tidak sebenarnya. Okay. Kita practice lagi satu soalan untuk adjoint method. Example 23. So, find the inverse of the following matrix by using adjoint method. Clearly in the question, they mention about adjoint method. Maksudnya, pakailah method tu. Sebab nanti all together kita ada 3 method. So, pakai adjoint. Soalan minta adjoint, pakailah adjoint. Okay. So, kita ulang semula step tadi. Step yang paling critical sekali. Step number 1. Step number 1, we have to find cofactor matrix. Okay, so find CV. So, cofactor matrix, open up big matrix. Dalam tu, kita letakkan 9 modulus berserta sign. Okay, so mesti start dengan positif. So, plus. And then we have minus. Plus. Then minus. Plus. Minus. And then last one, plus. Minus, plus. Okay, settled. Next, kita nak key in setiap nombor yang ada kat dalam tu. Start from the first row. Maksudnya, kita delete dulu first row. So, kalau first column, delete first column. So, we have 2, 0, 0, 1. Next, saya padam. Saya delete pula second column. So, we have 0, 0, 0, 1. Banyak kosong pula soalan ni. Hati-hatilah. And then kita delete pula third column. So, we get 0, 2, 0, 0. Settle for the first row. Now, saya padam balik. Kita delete pula second row. First column. So, our element would be 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay. After that, we delete the second column. So, we have 3, 0, 0, 1. Next one, kita delete pula third column. Kalau rasa dah boleh imagine dalam kepala, takkan buat salah kat situ. Tak payahlah tunjuk. Delete satu-satu ni tau. Saya buat sebab bersama-sama awak. So, saya tunjuklah satu-satu. Okay. Kalau dah boleh nampak, tak perlu nak delete tu. Teruslah tulis jawapan. Okay. Oh. Settle dah tadi second row. Okay. Now, third row. Third row, kita delete third row. First column. So, we have 0, 0, 2, 0. Pindah sebelah dia. Saya dah tak tunjuk eh. Kita terus dapatkan jawapan dia. So, 3, 0, 0, 0. And then last one, 3, 0, 0, 2. Okay. Settle kita. Tutup-tutup. Yang tutup-tutup ni. Make sure all 9 elements are correct. Okay. Next, yang ni pun kena hati-hati. Kita kena calculate one by one, buat darab lah. AD minus BC. Ada plus minus tu, careful eh. So, our final answer start with fit the first row, we will get 2, 0, 0. And then second row will be 0, 3, 0. Last one, 0, 0, 6. Settle. Dapatlah step number 1. Kita dah siap cofactor matrix dengan cantiknya. Okay. Nombor pun banyak kosong. Macam senang lah kat situ. Okay. Saya kecilkan sikit. Oh. Dia terlari. Okay. Okay. Dah siap. Now kita pindah pula ke step number 2. Step number 2. We have to transpose our cofactor. Find the adjoint. So, adjoint of B is basically cofactor matrix that we transpose. Jawapan kat set number 1 tadi kita transposekan. So, now interchange between row and column means that our adjoint here, start with the first column would be 2, 0, 0. Second column, 0, 3, 0. And then last column would be 0, 0, 6. Okay, kalau kita check kat sini, macam tak berubah kan? Kita dah transpose. Tapi jawapan macam sama. So, don't be surprised this can happen because this is basically symmetric matrix. Ada belajar kat dalam properties of transpose saya rasa. Matrix, kalau kita dah transposekan dia, dapat matrix yang sama, itu sebenarnya symmetric matrix. Okay, so jangan terkejut lah. Boleh. Benda tu boleh berlaku. Okay, settle step number 2. Now, kita proceed pergi step number 3. Step number 3, we have to find the determinant. Okay, determinant of B. Okay, ingat cara tadi, pilih satu row kat dalam soalan asal. So, pilih yang mana-mana. Yang penting, menyenangkan awak. Saya nak pilih last row lah. Okay, 0, 0, 1. And then, pilih satu row yang sama kat dalam cofactor matrix. Soalan step number 1 tadi. So, saya pilih third row kat situ. 0, 0, 6. So, kalau kita darabkan satu-satu situ. 0 times 0. 0 times 0. 1 times 6. Kita akan dapat 0 plus 0 plus 6. Means that our determinant is basically 6. Kalau awak pilih mana-mana row yang lain ataupun mana-mana kolom yang lain, awak still akan dapat jawapan yang sama. Okay, tak ada masalah. Alright. Itu option number 1. Option number 2, boleh juga kita cari determinant kalau kita tahu properties of determinant. This is basically diagonal matrix. Apa maksud diagonal matrix? All other entry are 0. Leading diagonal part je yang ada number. Okay, yang saya highlight colour kuning sekarang, itu je nombor dia. So, by using properties of determinant for diagonal matrix, the determinant of it would be the multiplication of leading diagonal entries. Hasil darab leading diagonal. So, boleh juga kita kira sebagai 3 times 2 times 1. Awak akan dapat 6. Boleh jugalah. Itu syarat dia kalau kita ingatlah properties determinant tu. Kalau tak ingat, buat cara manual tadi lah. Pilih satu row, pilih satu kolom. Okay. Dah settle step number 3, kita pergilah last step, step number 4, find the inverse using formula. So, remember our formula, D inverse is 1 over determinant times with its adjoint. So, saya masukkan 1 over 6 times kan dengan step number 2 punya jawapan. So, 2, 0, 0, 0, 3, 0, 0, 0, 6. Okay. And then macam saya dah pesan sebelum ni, make sure your final answer always as simplest form means it's in single matrix. So, we have to multiply scala inside. So, final answer start with the first row is 1 over 3, 0, 0. And then 0, half 0. Final one would be 0, 0, 1. So, that's basically how we find inverse matrix by using adjoint method. Altogether, we have 4 main steps. Step number 1, find our cofactor matrix. Step number 2, transpose our cofactor matrix in order to find the adjoint matrix. Step number 3, find the determinant. And last one for step number 4, compute everything into our formula. Kalau awak ikut step satu-satu, hati-hati bahagian sign, hati-hati mencari minor bila tutup-tutup tu, then for sure awak boleh dapat jawapan yang betul. And don't forget, you can check your final answer using calculator. Okay, that's all for this video.